By the way, this is the guy, not to interrupt you, who I want on the program. I went and saw Murderball. What a great freaking movie. And I think the star is doing interviews. We got to get him on the show.
Well, Vince Vaughn?
No, sorry, Jimmy. I totally interrupted you.
But I don't care.
I saw the guy from Murderball on TV, and it just...
what's his name?
I don't know his name. Basically, Murderball is a documentary about the paraplegic USA rugby team. And you would think these paraplegic guys would, you know, it'd be a cute little sport that they're doing to, you know, waste time.
Yeah.
They take it really, really seriously, and they showed that in this documentary. It was amazing.
I'd be very impressed if they played against people who aren't paralyzed.
Yeah, that's tough.
These guys, you know, redo their wheelchairs.
What was the name of the guy that played the ball? Cheap shot.
And they just bashed the crap out of each other with their wheelchairs.
Really?
Yeah, they redo their wheelchairs, make them really strong and sturdy, and it's unbelievable. It's a great documentary.
Like hit each other with their wheelchairs?
Oh, the hard, man.
Fly out of them?
Yeah, people are falling out of the wheelchairs, flipping. They take it really seriously.
They're not strapped in?
Yeah, they're strapped in pretty good.
So the wheelchair falls over and they're kind of just like...
Well, they need help getting up and stuff.
Oh,
but it shows, I got to tell you, I'm sure other people out there have seen this movie. They show that these guys are really athletes, and they train.
Yeah.
And they take it very seriously, and it's the real deal. And they're getting laid and everything.
Really?
They're getting laid. Most of these guys had girlfriends and stuff.
Yeah.
And I learned through the movie that, you know, even though you're paralyzed, you know, downstairs still works in most cases. And there's a video that they only show in the film for maybe 10 seconds. Because they showed this one kid who was a motocross guy that just got paralyzed.
Yeah.
That was part of the movie. It was a real drag. They showed him in rehab and trying to figure out what the hell he's going to do with his life. And by the end of the movie, it looked like he got very interested in maybe joining the rugby team, paraplegic rugby team. And they kind of showed him a video about how, yes, you could still have sex with your girlfriend back home. And they show this doctor in this video. And a really dry delivery, basically talking about, you know, what you have to do to have sex while you're in this
position. Do they got to pump it up or something?
Nah, supposedly you could still, you know, get hard and all that.
Still but get they showed, the blood in there?
They showed a girl completely naked, grabbing her, you know, paralyzed boyfriend.
Yeah.
In a, like kind of a bear hug and falling backwards onto the bed. And that's the only part of the video they showed. That video has to be out there somewhere. And,
Oh, we need it.
We need it, yeah. We need it.
Oh, we need it.
We definitely need it. So there's a project for someone out there to help us try to find that that sex video.
I'm sure it's in the credits. I'm sure it's in the credits of that movie.
But, you know, if you're looking for a different type of movie, Murderball was just really, really good. Really good.
You are Mr. Documentary.
Well,
you went to go see Murderball.
Murderball was awesome. Murderball was awesome, and we're going to have Mark Zupan on today, the star of Murderball. And I thought when I talked about Murderball the first time, about 2-3 weeks ago now, maybe 2 weeks ago, I was surprised because usually you throw something out there and then the phones, you know, start ringing like crazy and people want to comment about the shit we talk about, right?
Yeah.
Murderball, not one phone call. And it turns out that it hasn't really been released to the rest of the country yet, only in selected theaters in like New York, probably L.A. and a couple other big cities. That's it. But I guess they're now going to release this thing all over the place.
Yeah.
So we're going to talk to Mark Zupan about that today. Mark Zupan.
What's up?
Big fan, Mark. How are you?
I'm doing well.
I can't say enough about Murderball. Mark Zupan is the star of Murderball. Where are you calling from, Mark?
Austin, Texas.
Austin, Texas?
Yeah, I actually got to go home for 3 days or 4 days or whatever the hell it is.
You touring all over the place?
Yeah, I've been kind of running since, I think... 2 months ago.
Really?
Yeah.
I saw the movie about 2 or 3 weeks ago. I brought it to the program, you know, talked about it for about 20 minutes, and no one really called, which surprised me. And then I found out that it was only in limited release, and now they're going to release the movie all over the place, huh?
Right. I think it's this weekend it's going to get wide release. It was released last Friday on, I think, top 40 markets or... Kind of more of a limited, but a wider than it was before. So
right. You're starting to get recognized a lot?
Yeah, it's kind of weird. I mean, there was the weekly paper, the Austin Chronicle, they did a cover story. So I went out Saturday and shit, couldn't go into a bar. Like, oh, let me buy a beer.
Yeah, the free drinks rule, don't they?
God, you're not kidding. It was quite nice.
Well, you want to explain the movie to the newbies out there?
Sure. The movie's pretty much kind of like Jackass meets the NFL meets some psycho from a psycho ward. It's full contact wheelchair rugby, so you can hit somebody as hard as you possibly want to or can. And you get commended for it. You don't get punished or yelled at or what have you.
Yeah, these guys all have some form of disability, and they're just going hardcore into each other. It's a real sport. I thought, no offense, because I didn't know anything about this crap. I thought it was going to be a cute little thing. But you guys are true athletes. You work your asses off. The competition is amazing, and you take it seriously, and you're beating the crap out of each other trying to win the games, right?
Right. I mean, we're pretty much, I work a 50-hour week job, and I train. I'm in the gym lifting 10 to 12 hours at least, and then in my rugby chair, 10 to 12, just pushing to get endurance shape. And then to play, we play maybe 12 more hours on the weekend. So
doesn't leave much time for anything else.
Did you ever walk or no? Did you?
What's up?
Were you always in a wheelchair or no?
I didn't hear.
Were you always in a wheelchair?
Sorry. I got hurt when I was 18.
Story is crazy. You want to tell it, Mark?
Yeah, I can tell it. That's
right,
cool. We were.
How we got paralyzed.
Yeah.
Sorry to say it like that, but.
Yeah. I was out. I played college soccer. We were out after winning a game. I was drunk. My buddy was drunk. I wandered out of the bar, passed out in the back of his pickup. He didn't know I was back there. He wandered out about an hour later. And he hopped in the car and drove. He got lost, going down south in South Florida. Spun out, threw me out of the back of the pickup truck, over a fence, over some trees, into a canal where I spent 14 hours hanging onto a branch until somebody found me.
Wow. Holy shit.
Dude, he just wandered out of the bar, hammered.
What fucking odds of that happening?
And decided to just kind of pass out on the back of the pickup truck. And his friend had no idea he was back there.
Is your friend all right, or did he die, or did he live?
He was fine. Nothing happened.
Absolutely nothing happened to the guy.
He just got arrested.
Was he hammered?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Completely hammered.
God damn.
But now you guys are friends again, right? Because you went through a period where you weren't friends?
Yeah. It was
because you guys were like best friends, right? Or pretty close.
Yeah. He was my college roommate. He was, we went to high school together, and you'd have your years. I mean, we'd talk for a year, we wouldn't talk for a year, we would talk for two, we wouldn't talk for two. But what was cool about the movie is it brought us back together. We were sitting in Athens after the final game, and I looked at him. I said, "Do you ever think that we'd be here?" He kind of looks at me and goes, "Not really. I knew we were going to be somewhere, but not necessarily here." I'm like, "You ever think this is the best thing that's ever happened to me?" He kind of looked at me and goes, "Huh?"
Huh.
I go, "Do you ever think this is the best thing that's ever happened to me?" He goes, "Huh. That's interesting." I mean, I call him the Quad Father.
Oh, shit.
So we set up a website, quadfather.net. It's kind of funny. He's like, "Don't call me the Quad Father." Like, "Why, dude? You got to be pretty comfortable with it. You did make me." And he's like, "Oh, that's wrong, but I like it."
Jeez, really? There must have been some severe guilt on his part for quite a while.
Yeah, I mean, I think it was hard. I forgave him the instant he came into the... I was still in ICU. He came in, and he looked like a dog with his tail between his legs. I'm like, "What the fuck's the problem?" Mm. "Everything's fine." And I think that lightened it up on him a little, but I mean, he mentally and emotionally, he had to go through a hell of a time.
Well, it must not have been that easy for you either.
No, but I think it was easier.
Really? Like, that was how long ago? 10 years, maybe?
It was 12 years.
12 years? So yeah. I'm sure early on, you probably had quite a time with it.
Oh, of course. I mean, the first 2 years were difficult. I'm not gonna say they weren't.
Yeah.
You know, you have to figure out what the hell's going on with your life. You're 18 years old. Your independence you had just gotten your independence away from your parents, and you're having fun.
Yeah.
At school, and then you're thrown right back into your parents' house. You're like, "Oh, okay," but you're in a body that you're not familiar with. You got to learn how to shit, to piss, to eat, to dress, to just live.
Damn.
And once you figure it out, once you figure out that, you know, walking isn't the most important thing in life and you can find something else to do, and that's where I found rugby, and it opens the world. I mean, it just opens so many more opportunities. It offers.
Yeah, how did you find it?
It was just time. I mean, I found rugby initially about a month after I got hurt, but I was so focused on, oh, yeah, you know, wheelchair sports is cool, but I'm not going to need it because I'll be out of the chair in no time.
Oh, you had that going on?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. You know, a guy came over to my parents' house, and they put down a ramp, and he was gonna concrete bolt it to the step.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, no, dude, you don't have to worry about that. I'll be out of this thing in like 6 months. And
you should explain that, because when you're injured like that, there's so much swelling, and there are guys that do come out of it eventually.
Right.
And okay, then others, so, you know, after the 6 months, well, I hear up to like 2 years or something like that. And 2 years later, you're still hoping, well, the swelling's going to go down a little more. I'm going to get a lot more movement back. And unfortunately, it never happens for a lot of people.
Right. I guess the thing is, as long as you don't sever your spinal cord, you sever your spinal cord, then it's hard if the impulses even get down to your lower limbs.
Yeah.
An incomplete and complete injury. Complete means you severed your spinal cord. Incomplete is it means you may have done damage to the spinal cord, but you didn't completely disconnect the the impulses from the brain to the lower body.
Right.
So it's kind of like a frayed electrical cord.
What do you have?
I am a C6, C7 incomplete. So it's like a frayed electrical cord. Some impulses get down there, some impulses don't.
So is there a possibility that, you know, if they do stem cell or whatever, that you could walk again, or is that completely out of the question?
I don't know. I haven't really thought about it because it doesn't. If I could, I don't know if I necessarily would. I don't think I would.
Wow.
Just because.
That's interesting.
I've done and met so many people. And the chair, the chair to me is normal.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it doesn't bother me. Well, you look at it this way. I have a great ass level view of the world.
Do you find like, and I mean, to be in your situation, especially after having, like, you know, been mobile for 18 years, do you ever look at it like, all right, well, this, you know, it sucks on one level, but on another level, thank God it wasn't like, you know, what happened to Christopher Reeve, where like you have no mobility below the neck at all.
Well, I'm very, very fortunate to be where I am, but I don't look back and say, oh, I wish I was still walking, or I wish this, or I wish that.
Right.
I am very fortunate. I am fortunate to have the mobility that I have. Christopher Reeve, to be in his situation would be a hell of a lot more difficult.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I didn't really sit down and think about it. I am glad that I have the level and I am where I am. But I didn't really, you know, I never really sat down and thought about that.
Yeah. So how did you get into the rugby?
Well,
obviously you were an athlete growing up, and you know, when it was time to move on, you decided you wanted to be competitive again, right?
Yeah. I transferred to Georgia Tech from Florida. I was playing soccer at Florida Atlantic University, and I transferred to Georgia Tech about a year after I was hurt. And I was going to rehab up in Atlanta, and a lady who was my physical therapist was like, yeah, you know what, there's a game I think you might like. It's called rugby. I'm like, oh, yeah, I've heard of rugby. So she brought me down. Her husband, her boyfriend at the time, who's now her husband, played. So I hopped in, started playing, and the rest is history.
Yeah, and they, you know, you fix up your wheelchairs and everything. It's almost like, I don't know, you look like gladiators out there in a way.
Yeah, I mean, that's essentially what it's like. It's kind of like something from a Mad Max film.
Yeah, you got to see these wheelchairs. I mean, it's all metal, and it's just crazy.
It's like a projectile to an extent. You strap onto your ass projectile, and you
use it just to whale into other people.
Just and whaling. They showed in the movie where these guys are falling out of their chairs on their heads. I mean, it's nuts. You know, I got a friend. We met him through the radio show. It's Eddie from Big Brother. He won the first season of Big Brother. He has one leg. And he kept inviting me down to watch him play wheelchair basketball. And, I was clueless. I had no idea. You know, I thought, whatever. And I went down. I could not believe how competitive it was and how insane you guys are in the chairs. You know, he was playing wheelchair basketball where these guys were flipping and just crashing into the walls, each other, falling down, getting run over. It was nuts.
And your first instinct watching it is like, oh, no, someone help him.
Right. Oh, yeah.
You know?
Right.
Do you find that a lot of people have that image, like, you know, you're fragile almost and to be helped?
Definitely. You know, it's, I mean, people always feel like, oh, wait, I can't go talk to him. Oh, he might need some help. Let me go help him.
Mm-hmm.
The worst is if you're pushing up a hill and somebody gets behind you and starts pushing. You turn sideways and you're like, did I ask you to push me?
Right.
Don't touch me. That's annoying.
Turn you around and push you back down the hill. You go, smart ass.
What I love about the movie is that you guys obviously show that you're living normal lives, that you have a sense of humor. Yeah, these guys are pulling gags on each other and others, you know, mm-hmm. throughout the whole movie. One of his teammates has, what, no arms?
No arms, no legs.
No arms, no legs, basically. Just kind of
A quadruple amputee, yeah.
Yeah, stubs for arms.
Right.
And they're in a hotel, you know, and they put him in a box and then invite, like, who'd you invite in?
That was a physical therapist
Yeah, so, you know, it's a box that obviously would not fit a, quote, normal human being or whatever. And he's in there because he's so short because he has no limbs and all of a sudden kind of jumps out of the box and freaks out the lady. And I'm like, these guys rock. And most of you had girlfriends, right?
Yeah.
And and you explain in the movie that you're all having sex like crazy.
Yeah, I mean, everything works fine. It's a fun, fun time.
Thank God for that.
Was that, like, a big concern at first? Like, you know...
I mean, you're coming out of the hospital, and you're sitting in the hospital, and you're like, well, wait, let's see what works. And you're just laying in bed. You're like, oh, okay, this is still good. you gotta figure out if the equipment still works.
Of course.
Yeah.
So, yeah, they show these guys a tape on how they could still have sex.
Yeah, how funny was
that?
Funny was that sex? That sex ed vid.
I said on the air after I saw the movie that was really hilarious, and we have to get that film. It was pretty disturbing. I was hoping they were going to show more of that video during the film.
Actually, you know what might be interesting on the DVD extras?
Oh, really?
Yeah, I've heard that. I've never seen the full flick, but I heard it's pretty bad. It's like a 70s porn.
Really?
Ah, that's
great.
I mean,
it's that graphic.
Oh, so you haven't seen the film?
I've only seen
the excerpts or whatever.
Yeah, the excerpts of that.
They show this woman completely naked, grabbing her, you know, her boyfriend that, you know, is paralyzed in some way, and just giving him like kind of a hug, and then falling backwards onto the bed.
On the bed?
Yeah.
And start going at it.
And then they cut the footage. I thought it'd be pretty interesting to see what happens from there.
Yeah. What?
I think it could have been NC-17 if they would have put the whole video in.
Oh.
Yeah,
we gotta get our hands on it.
I can try to get it for you guys, though.
Definitely.
But it was. I loved the movie. I really did. I'm gonna go see it again. Matter of fact, Mark.
Cool. I appreciate it.
Knew that this the Paralympic Games? Who knew after the regular Olympics, whatever you want to call it, they had the Summer Paralympic Games using the same facilities in Athens.
Right.
And they just showed a montage of all the sports and these people just like taking it. Way, way serious, and it was really cool to see, you know, people running with one leg, with the metal leg and stuff, and and just going balls out, man.
Well, the Paralympics are the second biggest sporting event in the world,
yeah,
behind the Olympics, and I mean, we just don't get the Paralympics doesn't get the notoriety, it doesn't get the exposure that the Olympics does.
Yeah,
we don't get the funding. I mean, there's a lot of differences, but yet...
And you guys get really pissed off when they try to compare you to the Special Olympics.
Yeah.
Are you shitting me?
Well, the Special Olympics, that's, you know, where everyone's getting an award for just being there. These guys, it is the real deal. They're competing for the medals, and, you know, if they get the silver, then no, they really wanted the gold, and they're disappointed, just like the regular Olympics, you know?
I mean, we're one of... If you look at it this way, I was one of 12 people out of 500 that made the U.S. team. So it's not like, oh, yeah, well, you want to play? Well, why don't you just come join?
Yeah,
you,
right.
You don't just join. You got to try out. You got to bust your ass.
Mm-hmm.
So and the coach that is featured in Murderball, he was coaching the Canadian team. What a psycho.
Mm-hmm.
Really?
That's all I'll say for the people that are going to go see the film.
Is he a wheelchair or is he walking?
He's in a wheelchair.
He's in a wheelchair.
It looks like he's been in a wheelchair his whole life, but he is a psycho, man.
Yeah, he's a piece of work.
So
what irritates you, Mark? What irritates you most is when people are kind of like paternalistic and just trying to, you know, like kind of talk to you like you're not a complete person or
right.
that you constantly need their assistance of some sort.
Right. Well, what also happens if you're, say you're with somebody else, they'll talk to the other person. It's like, do you think he wants to eat?
You're kidding, right?
It's like, hey, people I'm right here. You can ask me if I want to eat.
Does he
want
to eat?
Just anything like that. It's like,
and there's a picture of Mark Zupan on the computer.
Holy shit.
Would you mess with him?
No.
On any level? No. Of course not. But they still think he's helpless because he's in a chair. Please.
All right.
This guy would kick your ass.
Damn. Upper body strength. Holy shit.
You look a little like Hetfield. Have you ever been told that?
Hetfield?
Yeah, for across the room.
I haven't heard Hetfield. I've heard... I don't even... There's comparisons to Alexi Lalas. There's comparisons to...
Yeah.
But no, I haven't heard Hetfield. That's actually quite a compliment. Thanks.
A little bit.
Very, very good. So... All right. Hey, what about the guy in the movie, the motocross guy?
Keith?
Yeah.
This is kind of cool. I got a...
That was really sad. Just to bring everyone on the same page here, part of the movie is they show this guy, Keith, who was pretty big in the motocross world, and he got paralyzed, and they show him, in the hospital just starting his new journey. And, man, it was very interesting by the end of the film. But go ahead, Mark.
Well, what's good, what Keith embodies is he's like the every quad. He is me. He is Andy. He is Scott when we were young. I mean, they could have put in the film just us explaining it, but just to see it, to see the trials, the tribulations that he goes through, makes it just so much more. But what was cool is Keith, I went and spoke at his rehab hospital, and we put him in my rugby chair, I brought it, and he just lit up like a kid in a candy store.
Yeah.
I mean, he was so happy. He's like, wow, I didn't know this was possible. I didn't know there were other things to do to be competitive at. So for the premiere in New York, I was talking to a lady, I think probably about 3 months before. She's like, I saw the movie in Boston. I want to donate some money. I'm like, all right. She's like, I want to buy Keith the chair. So... got the money, got him a chair, and I surprised him at the New York premiere. Everyone was standing up. We called all the subjects down. And he was on the left side of the theater. Since everyone was standing, I snuck down the right side with his chair. I called him up, and he just, again, was blown away. He goes, wait, this is mine? I get to take this home with me? I'm like, yeah, Keith, this is all yours. And I think he finally played on... Monday. So, we'll see.
What do one of those things go for?
About $3,500.
Wow, pretty steep.
So you're sitting there, you're paying $3,500 just to beat the shit out of it.
Yeah, and you guys do. All right, Mark. Thank you so much for calling the show today.
Thanks for having me.
It's Murderball. It's going to be released all over the country, I guess, starting Friday, huh?
Yeah, it's in certain theaters now, but it's going to go wider. I know it's going to open in Atlanta this weekend, Cleveland this weekend, I think D.C. this weekend.
Yeah, I really enjoyed the movie. I mean, you guys, it was inspirational, sir.
Well, I appreciate that.
All right.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Man. Take it easy, man.
Mark Zupan, the star of Murderball. And there you have it.
It's funny, every guy, when he was talking, every guy, what every man first thinks is, does your dick work? That's the first thing as a man.
That's instant feedback wise.
You want it, but it's like, I don't know if that's out of line to ask. Like,
really?
He mentioned it. I don't know, man. I don't know. There's certain questions you might ask that are just like you know, again, that might be like the push up the hill of questions, like where it's just an insult and you don't want to do that.
Yeah, that's why sometimes it's uncomfortable. You just don't know what's appropriate or not.
You just don't want to be a shithead. Like,
we're
you know?
All stupid.
Well, the best part is when he brought up the film. Saying, wasn't that hilarious? Yeah. I'm like, oh, good, you do have a sense of humor, because the video is ridiculous, actually.
I got to see that.
It's ridiculous. Well, we've been trying to find it. We're trying to find the video that was featured in Murderball. So, naked woman just, like, grabbing the guy and just falling backwards onto the bed to get him up on the bed, and that's when they didn't show any more footage. I want to see what happens next.
You'd think if he was offered a miracle cure to walk... that he wouldn't take it.
Of course. It's almost like, and it's like you're listening to a guy talking, he's telling the truth, But it's almost like, I think, in anything, and I, again, I'm not speaking from experience, but you get to a point where you kind of accept, okay, this is the way it is.
Resign to the fact. Here it is.
It is what it is. I'm doing fine here.
Mm-hmm.
But to get my hopes up or to think about the other option is, you know, inexcusable.
Yeah, it's it would probably just prey on you every day, so you might as well just say, no, this is my life now. This is what I'm doing. If offered this miracle cure that could make me walk, I wouldn't take it, blah, blah, blah.
Stevie Wonder may say, I wouldn't take sight, and it may be believable because I don't think he ever saw something. If you've never had something,
yeah,
maybe you can't picture life without it. But if you walked if you're 18 and then you've been hurt for 11 years, I mean, it's, I don't know. I'm not
no,
hurt,
I think even Stevie Wonder would want sight.
Maybe. I'm just saying if you're born a certain
Just out of curiosity, you know, you're living in a world where just about everyone sees and, you know, you'd want to know what it's all about.
Mm. Probably. I don't know.
Hmm.
He's doing fine without us.
He seems to be.
He sure can play the piano. I'm going to get a lot of them are musical people.
Let's go to Mike in Jersey. Mike, what's up?
Hey, guys. What's up?
Hey.
I saw Murderball over the weekend. It was unbelievable. I got to thank you for mentioning it.
Oh, very good. Yeah, I love that movie.
Oh, it was fantastic.